Hi, this is the circuit diagram of how I connected node MCU module with the 4-channel relay mode. So here I am connecting D0, D1, D2 and D5 of node MCU as output pin and connected 4 relay with these 4 output pins. First, this is a relay. This has 5 pins. So here 2 pins are your input pins and these 3 pins your output, where you have to connect the AC devices. There is one is pole, one is NC and another one is NO. So by default pole and NC are connected, but here is your input pin where you have to give the 12 volt as well as ground. So here this pin is your 12 volt pin. You have to connect 12 volt over here, and then this is connected, these two pins are, the diode is connected across these two pins for a protection purpose. Then I am connecting a resistor of 330 ohm. And the LED. The negative of the LED is connected with the positive of the diode, and if the relay is on, the LED will be glow, and when the relay is off, the LED will be off. So this pin is connected with 12 volt, so I need this pin to be connected to ground so that the relay will be on. So before I connected to the ground, I connected an NPN transistor. In the basically NPN transistor will be switched on if I give any positive voltage to the base of the NPN transistor. So I connected this the base of the NPN transistor with the output pin of your node MCU module. So here is the output pin D5, and through a resistor of 1 kilo ohm I connected to the base. If when I press the switch using the BLYNK app, the D5 pin gives the output 1 and this gives the transistor on. And this pin, the collector, is connected with the one end of your diode, and this is one end of the relay module also. And then the emitter pin is connected with the ground of your node MCU. So when I press the key on the BLYNK app, the D5 pin will give a pulse high output, and this makes the transistor on. When the transistor on, the this pin of your relay is connected with the ground of coming from your node MCU module, and by default this pin is connected with 12 volt, so relay will be on. So anything, any AC appliances you are connecting to this output of the device will glow. So in this way you can connect another 3 relay module and connect it to these 3 pins of your node MCU. So so by this you can connect 4 devices, as well as you can connect as more devices you want to this module, and you can control that over internet. So our rectifier module I connected with ground, as well as VU pin available on the node MCU module. I specify that VU pin because VIN pin, when I give the 5 volt power from the rectifier, it does not switch on. So please check that you have to give the power to the VU pin so that the node MCU will be powered on. So according to this, you can connect the diagram that I have written on this BLYNK node MCU module, so that I can control over the BLYNK app. Here is the loop, and it runs always and checks that BLYNK is connected or not. In this program, I also discuss about this program in my previous video. So please check that video. You have the idea how to control, how to connect BLYNK with your node MCU module. So by writing this program on your node MCU module, you can control any AC devices over internet. Here I am going to use my Lolin node MCU ESP8266 module, as well as I am connecting 4 relay over here, and this is a power supply board, and this is a transformer, step down transformer. So here my power is coming, and here is 230 volt AC, and it converted into 12 volt AC. This is step down transformer. Then this power is going to this rectifier board, and here I am getting two different kinds of DC voltages. One is for 7805 for giving 5 volt DC, and another one is 7812 for giving 12 volt DC. Then the 12 volt supply is giving to these 4 relay board, because this relay are 12 volt relay modules, and this works only on 12 voltage DC supply. Then the 5 volt is required for this Lolin node MCU module, where the 5 volt is supplied. Then this module is the IOT device that is contains the ESP826 module, as well as it has its own memory. In my previous tutorial, I show you how to connect ESP826 module with a BLYNK application. So here, using this technique, I am going to control 4 different devices connected to the relay output, and we are going to control these 4 devices using the BLYNK application. So first of all, you have to connect the components according to the circuit diagram.
So far after the rectification, you have to connect this module, and the output of this module that I programmed connected using BLYNK app, and the outputs are connected to the four input of this relay module. And this relay module is I made by a PCB, dotted PCB board. You can also purchase a four channel relay module online also, so that will be easier for you. If you know the soldering and you know the circuit diagram, you can connect the components according to the circuit, and you can make your own relay module at your home also. So after connection is successful, in this low-link node MCU module, there is a VU pin where you have to give the input voltage of 5 volt and ground. 5 volt and ground is coming from this power supply module. Then the four output of this node MCU will connect to the relay module. Then after connecting the four supply, then there is a reset pin. You have to place the reset pin after giving the power supply so that it can connect to the internet and you can control the devices from the internet. Let me power on the device first. Okay, now the device is powered on. The LED glows, that indicates that power is coming to this module, and I am getting the power to the low-link module as well as node MCU module as well as the relay module. Then I am pressing the reset switch, and after pressing the reset switch, let's check that my device is connected or not. Wait a minute. I show you how to create a BLYNK app in my previous tutorial. If you want, please check my previous tutorials. After that, you can also check that which pins these are connected. One is D0, another one is D1, and then D2 and D5. These four pins, four output pins, I am going to use for controlling the relay at the output. After pressing that, okay. Now let's put my mobile here so that you can check the output precisely. Okay. Now I am going to. All the modules are currently off. Let's on it. Now off means the current status is off of all the output devices. Let on. All the devices are on. You can connect all your AC appliances using these two pins of a relay output. Any AC appliances you can connect. You can connect your lights, fans, fridge, any AC appliances, you can connect with these pins so that it will be on and off according to the command given by your phone over internet. My phone is connected currently to my own mobile's data, and this device is connected to my home Wi-Fi. So this is totally two different Wi-Fi connections, and the devices are working over internet. So this is the simplest Internet of Things device you can make at your home by purchasing relay components as well as a Node MCU Wi-Fi module, and this is very cheaper currently available in India. So I think you can make your own home appliances and control over internet and enjoy. Thank you. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you all.